My first encounter with a hummingbird was when a young man came to our one-room school where I was in first grade, so I was six. So he performed some magic, which was pretty interesting, and showed us all kinds of things. But at the end, he pulled out a little box, a little bit bigger than a matchbox, and opened it up and let us look inside, and there was the specimen of a hummingbird in there. In German, they were called colibri. So he told us that that bird could fly up and down and backwards and forwards, and it was too tiny to believe, really. So I wasn't quite sure what to think about that bird, because after all, he was a magician. So I thought this was another trick, maybe. But it stuck in my mind as, maybe these things did exist.
I think it's really important to study hummingbirds now because from a health standpoint, since we know so little about them, if they start having problems, or maybe even they're having problems now and we don't know about it, we won't have any baseline to go from. And so in order to prevent problems in the future and also to identify problems now, we feel like it's critically imperative to establish what's normal and then try to address what we can do in the future to save populations. No one in the country except University of California, Davis and University of Wyoming are actually studying their health. If we do this work now, we'll be able to enjoy them in the future. But also from the bird standpoint, I feel like since some of the impacts that are going to be affecting the birds are doing, we owe it to the birds themselves too.
A world without birds for me would be a catastrophe. You know, that would be unimaginable.